We will start with Kapalabhati, fast nostril breathing. Keep your back straight, shoulders relaxed. We will focus on the abdomen. With the inhalation, the abdomen goes out. And with the exhalation, the abdomen goes in. And once we start with the round, you are forcefully going to exhale from the nose, pulling your abdomen in this way. You do not think of the inhalation is passive, so it's only forceful exhalations. I'll be counting one and two. On the count of one, you exhale. On the count of two, just relax your abdomen, and the inhalation will happen by itself. Close your eyes. First round, inhale. Begin. Exhale. To retain the breath in, inhale 90% of your lungs capacity and hold your breath in comfortably, shifting the focus to the point in between your eyebrows when you retain the breath. With control, exhale. Second round, inhale, begin. Second retention, inhale, hold your breath in comfortably. You can exhale anytime if you feel any discomfort or pressure in the lungs. With control, exhale, last round, inhale, begin. Control, exhale. Last two fingers together, right elbow close to the chest, keep your right shoulder relaxed. We use the thumb for the right nostril and the last two fingers for the left. I exhale first. Now, close the right nostril with your thumb. Through the left, inhale one, up two, up three, up four. Close both nostrils and hold your breath. Right, exhale one. Up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Right, inhale one, up two, up three, up four. Close, retain. Left, exhale one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Left, inhale one, up two, up three, up four. Hold. Right, exhale one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Right, inhale one, up two, up three, up four. Close, retain. Left, exhale one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Left, inhale one, up two, up three, up four, hold. Right, exhale one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Inhale one, up two, up three, up four, hold. Left one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Left inhale one, up two, up three, up four. Hold. Right, exhale one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight. Inhale one, up two, up three, up four, hold. one, on two, on three, on four, on five, on six, on seven, on eight. Inhale, one, on two, on three, on four. Right, one, on two, on three, on four, on five, on six, on seven, on eight. Inhale, one, on two, on three, on four. Last redemption. Left, one, on two, on three, on four, on five, on six, on seven, on eight. Relax your right hand down. Keep the focus on the breath as you slowly lie down on the back in Shavasana without opening the eyes. Just observe your breath and observe your body. Take your arms behind you, interlock your fingers and stretch up. And exhale, release on your right side and lower slowly stand up. To start with Surya Namaskar, the sun salutation, we will do 6 rounds. Stand at the front of your mat with your feet together, arms relaxing by the sides of your hips. Inhale. Exhaling, palms together. Inhale, both arms up, hips forward, arch in the back. Exhale, stretch forward and down. Fingertips and toes and warm up. Right leg back, knee on the floor. Inhale. Plank, hold your breath. Exhale, knees down, chest down, forehead down. Inhale, up to cobra, arch the back. Exhale, to inverted V, hips up, chest down. Right foot forward, inhale. Left, exhale. Inhale, stretch forward and up, arch the back. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Left leg back, inhale. Hold your breath, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, and forehead. Inhale, up to cobra, arch the back. Exhale, to invert. Left foot forward, inhale. Right leg, exhale. Inhale, forward and up, arch the back. Exhale. Arms together, inhale. Exhale, down. Right leg back, inhale. Plank, hold your breath. Exhale, down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, inverted. Right foot forward, inhale. Exhale, left. Inhale, forward, arch the back. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, down. Left leg back, inhale. Hold your breath, plank. Exhale, down. Inhale. Exhale. Left foot forward, inhale. Exhale, right. Inhale, up, arch the back. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Right leg back, inhale. Hold your breath, plank. Exhale, down. Inhale. Exhale. Right leg forward, inhale. Exhale, left. Inhale, up, arch the back. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Left leg back, inhale. Hold, plank. Exhale, down. Inhale, cobra.
Exhale inverted. Left foot forward. Inhale. Exhale. Palms together. Exhale. Right hand back. Hold your breath plank. Exhale down. Exhale inverted. Right hand forward. Inhale up, arch the back. Exhale. Palms together. Inhale up. Exhale down. Left leg back. Inhale. Hold your breath. Plank. Exhale down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, inverted. Left leg. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Arch the back. Exhale. Two more. Palms together. Inhale. Exhale. Right leg. Inhale. Hold. Plank. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Right leg. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Palms together. Inhale. Exhale. Left leg. Inhale. Hold. Plank. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Left leg. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Arch the back. Exhale. Find the ground. Exhale down. Right. Inhale. Plank. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Right leg. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Left leg. Inhale. Hold. Plank. Exhale. Deep. Inhale. Cool. Exhale. Left. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Up. Arch the back. And exhale. Relax, separate your legs. Relax your hands by your side. Palms turned forward, eyes are closed. Calm down your breath. Slow inhalations and long exhalations. Lie down on the back and relax Shavasana. Keeping legs apart and arms apart. Back of the hands on the mat. Relax on here. Slowly feet together, arms behind you, interlock your fingers and stretch. Exhale, release. Keep the hands by the sides of the hips. Feet together, flexing the toes back. Right leg up, inhale. Without bending your knees, exhale, right leg down. Left, straight leg, inhale. Exhale. Right, inhale. Exhale. Left, inhale, exhale, right, inhale up, catch your right leg anywhere you're comfortable without bending your knees, and slowly lift your head up and chest up. Hands only come up if both knees are straight. Release. Close your eyes and relax. Put your head down just now, bend your right knee, interlock your fingers, hugging your thigh, close your abdomen. Exhale, head up again, chin or forehead to the knee, make sure your shoulders are relaxed, breathe. Keep your knee bent. Just relax your head for a moment. Now inhale, head up again. Let's hug the right lower leg. So you take your right foot as close as you can to the left upper arm. Roll your arms around the lower leg. If you cannot hold like this, just hold anywhere you can. The point is to bring the lower leg closer to the chest so we can stretch the hip. Breathe. Try to keep the left leg straight. A gentle pressure to bring the lower leg closer to your chest. Breathe. Only if your toes are close enough to your left ear, only then you can move to option two. Take your right arm behind your head and hold your right big toe with your right hand. This is only an option if your right toe is close to the ear. Also, you can release the hand if you are comfortable, otherwise keep holding the leg with the hand to get a deeper stretch. Good, release, hug for a moment here. Releasing the hands, inhale, right leg up, head down, exhale, right leg down to the left. Inhale, left leg up, catch your left leg, exhale, slowly head up, chest up. Both knees are straight, we hold. Breathe, close your eyes. Head down, chest down, bend your left knee, interlock your fingers, hug your thigh, close to your abdomen. As you exhale, bring your head up again, bring the shoulders relaxed. Put head down, chest down for a moment. Inhale. Exhale, raise your head up again. Hug your left lower leg now, any way you feel comfortable. And try to bring the lower leg closer to your chest. Breathe. Otherwise, just keep holding it here and stretching your hip. Slowly we release the head down. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left leg down to come up. Keeping the legs together, palms by your side. If you have lower back pain, then keep your hands underneath your back. Otherwise, by your side. Inhaling both legs up. Exhaling both legs down. Inhaling up. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up, stay up. Head up, chest up, arms off the floor. Breathe. If you're comfortable, we lower halfway down. Breathe. You can release anytime if you feel uncomfortable. Inhale up. Exhale one more time down. Hold and breathe. And slowly exhale, relaxing down in Shavasana for the moment. You can move your neck from side to side if there's any tension in the bend. And then back to the center. Legs together, stretch your arms behind you. And exhale, please turn on the side and slowly come up and come to child's pose. Sit back at the end of your mat and relax your arms by the sides of your body, forehead on the floor. Head up, chest up. We do a small exercise instead of dolphin, just to work on the shoulders as well, same as the benefits of dolphin is to strengthen the shoulders and the abdomen in preparation for shasana or headstand. So stretch your arms in front of you into extended child's pose and slowly come up to inverted knee. Hips up and chest down. As you breathe, take your right leg up high and see. Exhale, shift forward to plank, bend your right knee and try to touch the right knee to the right upper arm. Inhale up. Exhaling to the left. Inhaling. Exhale to the right. In up. Exhale to the left. Inhale. Exhale to the right. Inhale up. Exhaling left. Inhale up. Exhale to the right and we hold on the right side. Make sure you are using your shoulders properly after the top fit. Inhale back to the center. Exhale to the left. Hold and breathe. Inhale up. And exhale right like that. We change sides. Inhale left leg up. Exhale, knee to the left, forearm, upper arm. Inhale up. Exhale to the right, upper arm. Inhale up. To the left. Inhale. Exhale right. Inhale. Exhale left. Inhale up. Exhale right. Inhale up, exhale left, hold and breathe. Inhale up, to the right, exhale, hold and breathe. Inhale up and exhale down. Relax and try.
Stand Shirshasana. You can go ahead for the practice of headstand. If you don't practice headstand, you can simply lie down just for a few seconds and wait in Shavasana, or go ahead for a shoulder stand, meanwhile, standing up on the shoulders. Otherwise, we will do just a few seconds up in headstand. We measure the distance between forearms, interlock your fingers, head on the mat.
And slowly we walk forward and come up to headstand. Slowly landing the knees, release. Staying in child pose just for a few seconds. Now on the back foot, Sarvangasana, shoulder stand.
Arms on the floor, inhale slowly, both legs up, hips up, and support your back.
Close your eyes and breathe, try to relax your legs and your whole body. Optional only if you are comfortable, you can release the support of the back, either placing the hands on the mat behind you or interlocking the fingers and placing them on the mat. Try to keep your body as straight as you can. You can support the back anytime if you need to. Now slowly right leg down behind your head. Inhale up. Exhale, left leg down. Inhale up. Right leg. Inhale. Left leg. Inhale. Halasana. Exhale, slowly both legs down behind you. If your toes only are on the floor, you keep your hands on the mat, interlocking the fingers. Otherwise, it's better to support the back. Breathe. Support your back. You can always roll out of the posture all the way down to Shavasana from here, or you can come. come up to shoulder stand and then come to the bridge from shoulder stand by bending your knees. Either one leg after the other, going down to the floor, or both together, slowly with control, going down to the mat. If you're already on the floor in Shavasana, come up to the bridge, bending the knees, keeping them hip distance apart, and lifting your hips up. You have option of either staying in the bridge or slowly come up to the V, Chakrasana, hands underneath the shoulders and lifting up. And exhale, slowly releasing down. Hug your legs, bringing your thighs close to your abdomen, and massage your back, right and left. And back to the center. Legs straight on the floor, format Matsyasana push. Arms underneath your body. Inhaling up on the forearms. Exhale, touch the head, but keep the weight on the arms. Inhale up and exhale down to Shavasana. Relax. Slowly roll your neck from side to side, right and left. And back to the center. Relax. Together, take your arms behind you, interlock and stretch back. Exhale, release. Turn on the side and slowly sit up. We stretch the legs forward. Now bend your left leg and hug it, rolling the arms around the left leg, keeping the back straight and the right leg straight. You just rock the knee in and out to stretch the hip. Now keep the leg on the center and just hug your lower leg closer to the chest. Back straight, breathe. And stay. Option one is just keeping the foot on your right inner thigh. Option two is placing the foot on top of your thigh. Make sure if you are in half lotus that the knee is close enough to the floor. If your knee is very much up high, then it's better to stick with option one. Good. Now from here, inhaling both arms up. And we're going to exhale, coming down for the breath. Also, a second option only for those who are in half lotus. If you want to, you can bring your left hand behind the back, catching your left big toe and going down with the right palm. Make sure you are breathing placing the hands in hip width arms up. Exhaling your hands down. We stay with the same leg, so we're still bending the left leg. Bend your right, catch your right foot. Keep the balance on your sitting bones. Back is straight and slowly raise your right leg. Release the right leg down and stretch your left leg forward. You can move it up and down. We change sides, bend your right leg and hug your right lower leg. Keep the spine straight and let's drop the knee in and out. Good. To the center, hug it tightly towards your chest. Breathe, keep your back straight. Slowly down, option one, foot on your inner thigh, option two, on top of your inner thigh. Inhale, option one, the arms fold, arms up and going down. For those who are in Ardha Padmasana, you can try to bring the right hand behind you, catching the big toe and slowly coming down. Relax your neck and your head and breathe. Inhale, stretch your arms forward and up. Exhale down. Same way now, we bend the left leg. You can keep the foot down on the floor if you feel it's not possible to do this balancing without keeping the leg on the thigh. And slowly we stretch up. Try to keep the back as straight as you can. And breathe. And slowly release the leg down. Stretch your right leg forward and your knees up and down. Feet together, inhaling both arms up. Exhaling, folding forward from the hips. Holding the legs anywhere you feel comfortable and slowly relaxing. Slowly using your abdomen all the time. Inhale, stretch your arms forward and up. Exhaling, place your both hands back behind you. Point your ten toes down to the mat and slowly inhaling, hips up, chest up, and dropping the neck. Exhaling, release your hips. Come to child's pose. Relax your forehead on the floor, arms by your side. Now we stretch the arms forward and extend the child's feet. And we come up to inverted V, hips up, chest down. Inhale, take your right leg up. Exhale, take your right foot forward in front of you, in between the hands. Relax your left knee and your left toes. Move your right hand inside your right foot. Make sure you are stretching your left hip forward. Relaxing the hands here, the head and the shoulders. Take a breath. If you are comfortable, you can lower your forearms down to the mat and relax your forehead anywhere you're comfortable. Breathe. Inhaling back on the hands, we come from here to pigeon, Kapotanasana. Just slide your right lower leg down on the mat behind your hands. Make sure to keep your left hip facing down and slowly walk forward with your hands and relax on the right lower leg. Close your eyes and breathe. With every exhalation, you are relaxing your hips more down. Slowly walk back with your hands. Straighten up your back as much as you can. Make sure the left hip is still facing down, okay? Don't turn this way. Keep your hip facing down and make sure you're not hunching, shoulders are back at the top. Breathe, looking up. You can stay here or if you are comfortable, try to bring the hands in front of your heart center. Slowly hands down. Now bend your left leg. And try to catch your left foot with your left hand, bringing your left hip closer to the body. Again, make sure you don't turn to the right side. Keep your left hip facing down. These are all options. You can always stay in the basic one. If you can now slide the foot on your elbow, maybe catching the fingers together and slowly raising your elbow up. Last option would be king pigeon. This is only an option. Those who practice king pigeon can go ahead for the full one. And slowly releasing down. Tuck your left toes under and very slowly take your right leg back. Let's walk up and down with the heels, relaxing the lower back and the right leg. We change sides, inhale your left leg up, exhale left foot forward, right knee down, toes relax. Move your both hands inside your left foot. You can either stay here and just stretch your right leg forward, or lower your forearms down and relax your head. Inhaling back on the hands, let's slide the left lower leg to the mat. Right hip is still facing down and slowly walk forward with the arms and relax on your left lower leg. Breathe.
Slowly walk back with your hands, keeping your both hips again facing forward, shoulders back and down, looking up and breathe. Same mantra if you're comfortable, hands in front of your chest. Hands up. Bend your right leg and catch the right foot with your right hand and try to bring the right knee closer to your right hip. If you can slide your elbow, you place the elbow behind the foot, interlocking the finger and stretching the elbow up. This is only again an option. Breathe. And again, the last option for those who practice here. Pigeon can go ahead for the full one. And slowly releasing down. Again, tuck your right toes under and slowly come back to inverted V. Walking up and down with the heels. And then slowly relaxing for a moment in child's pose. Sit on the heels, forehead down and arms raised. Head up, chest up. We do the spinal twist, Ardha Matsyendrasana. Sit on the right side of your hips, taking the heels away. Left foot outside your right knee. Keep the heel outside the butt. Left arm behind you. Inhale, stretch your right arm up. Exhale, either hug the leg and your back or bring your elbow outside the knee and over your left shoulder. Inhale, right arm up. Exhale, left. Change. We sit on the left. Right foot outside the left knee. Right arm behind the back. Inhale, up. Exhale, twist and look over your right shoulder. Left arm up. Exhale, down. Bend your both knees and hug them towards you. Straightening up the back. Inhale, chin up. Exhale, down. Inhale, back. Exhale, down. To the center, to the right. To the left. To the right. To the left. The center, right into the right shoulder, and to the left, and up to the center. Kapotanasana, crow pose up on the toes. You can always balance this way, or you can go ahead with your crow, bending your knees, bending your elbows, place your knees on your upper arms, hips up, and slowly shift forward, one leg at a time. Breathe. And slowly releasing that. Inhale, come up. And exhale. Rotate your wrists. We keep the legs together. Inhaling both arms up. And slowly exhaling forward. Catch your opposite elbows, relax your head, and keep the weight forward towards the toes. Completely relax your upper body and breathe. Your head and shoulders are like a pendulum, completely hanging with every exhalation.
the hands. Inhale, stretch forward and up. Exhaling, release. Trikonasana mantra, you're opening the legs slightly more than hip distance apart. Inhale, take your left arm up. As you exhale, you go sideways to the right. Chin away from the chest. Breathe. Inhale up, exhale down. Change right arm up. Inhale, exhale left. Inhale up and exhale. Bring your feet together. Interlock your fingers, stretch up and come up on the toes. Exhale, release. We come to the final relaxation. Lie down on your back and relax in Shavasana. Lengthen arms and legs. Have your eyes gently closed. Just begin by taking a few deep abdominal breaths. Now let go of the breath and shift your attention down to your toes. Mentally say, I relax my toes. My toes are relaxed. Relax my feet and my toes. My feet and my ankles are relaxed. Relax my calves and my shins. My calves and my shins are relaxed. Relax my knees and my thighs. My knees and my thighs are relaxed. Relax my hips. My hips are relaxed. Relax my lower back, middle back, and upper back. My lower back, middle back, and upper back are relaxed. Relax my abdomen. My chest, my abdomen, my chest are relaxed. Relax my fingers and palms, forearms, elbows, and upper arms. My arms are relaxed. Relax my shoulders, my neck, and my head. My shoulders, neck, and head are relaxed. Relax my face, chin, jaw, and lips, nose, and cheeks. Eyes and forehead. My face is relaxed. My whole body is relaxed. toes and fingers. Moving your neck from side to side. Back to the center, legs together. Arms behind, interlocking the fingers. We stretch the whole body back. And exhaling, release. We turn on the right side, bending the knees close to the abdomen. And then slowly up to a seated position. Cross your legs any way you feel comfortable. Hands and chin on the knees. We conclude together. Inhale to chant home.
Together. Namaste. Thank you.